GPT-4, the largest and the most powerful model on Earth, has been available for a few months, but nobody still understands how it works. When GPT-4 solves a coding problem that you have been struggling with for hours in a few seconds, it does honestly feel like magic. But if it's so magical, why did Sam Altman think that you would be disappointed by its release?
People are begging to be disappointed, and they will be. The hype is just like, we don't have an actual AGI, and I think that's sort of what is expected of us, and yeah, we're going to disappoint those people.
Indeed, the recent rumors hint that GPT-4 may not be as evolutionary after all. Rather, it could simply be an old trick reimagined, cleverly repackaged by OpenAI for a handful of strategic purposes. So in this video, I'll delve into the latest whispers about GPT-4 architecture, aiming to demystify its inner workings to help you navigate the AI landscape effectively and gain valuable insights. Let's dive in. The rumors surrounding the GPT-4 architecture originated from George Hotz, America's top hacker who was sued by Sony at 21 years old for jailbreaking PlayStation and who is now running one of the top self-driving AI startups called Coma AI.
So, you know, it's a mixture model. They just trained the same model 8 times. And then they have some little trick. They actually do 16 inferences.
Sam Altman won't tell you that GPT-4 has 220 billion parameters and is a 16-way mixture model with 8 sets of weights.
Who did you have to murder to get that information?
According to Hotz, GPT-4 is a mixture model. Right now, it's worth noting that several other notable figures in the field have supported Hotz's claims. For example, Soumit Chintala, co-founder and lead of PyTorch, and Mikhail Parakhin, Microsoft Bing AI lead, have both hinted at similar notions. And while it's important to note that these speculations remain unconfirmed, other factors like, for example, OpenAI hiring one of the people who basically invented mixture models and a couple more engineers who worked on them, of course, at Google, suggest that this is a very real possibility. But to understand why all of this makes sense and what it means for the future of AI, you first need to understand what mixture models are and how they function. Essentially, a mixture model is just a few smaller models combined. That's it. Instead of training one large model, you simply train a few sub-models called experts that specialize in certain parts of the input space. You then combine them together with a gating mechanism so the system as a whole decides which experts should be used to make a prediction. It's like having a team of doctors, each with their own area of expertise. Each doctor is an expert in their own field. Now, when the patient arrives, you don't just randomly assign them to any doctor. You consult with the nurse, the gating mechanism, who decides which doctor should see the patient. Just like in a hospital, the goal of the system is to provide the best possible care for the patient, or in the case of the mixture model, to make the best possible prediction. But to simplify it even further, GPT-4 can be thought of 8 ChatGPT models combined. Each ChatGPT model inside GPT-4 is trained for a different part of the input space. For example, one learns to solve coding problems, another creative tasks, and a third math-related questions. All these models work together, so you never have to do your homework again. Now, the big question is, why would OpenAI keep such an old and relatively simple technique a secret? And the answer is just as simple. By keeping it a secret, OpenAI was able to fool public's imagination about superintelligence and AGI. By pushing a narrative about godlike AI, they scared any potential competitors out of the game and pushed for more regulation, preventing smaller companies and open source communities from entering the field.
But the easiest would be to talk about the amount of compute that goes into such a model. We could define a threshold of compute and it'll have to change. It could go up or down. Down as we discover more efficient algorithms that says above this amount of compute, you are in this regime.
This not only grabbed headlines and attracted attention, but also helped them to secure funding and maintain a competitive advantage over their rivals who were relying on more traditional techniques. And finally, one last question is, what does this all mean for the future of AI and model development? Well, the good news is that future innovation may come from different areas that aim to make AI models more flexible and adaptable rather than super intelligent or just extremely large. This means that maybe open source still has a chance. And the bad news is that it might mean that we have already hit the ceiling and the singularity is not as near. You see, mixture models originated from data science competitions where they are only used at the very end. Basically, you use mixture models only when you run out of all your other ideas. And while I am certain that OpenAI has added their own special touch to this old technique, it is unlikely to be as magical as we once thought. As Raymond Joseph Taylor once said, sometimes magic is just someone spending more time on something than anyone else might reasonably expect. So, did OpenAI really run out of ideas, or did they invent something magical and spread these rumors on purpose? Let me know in the comments. And if you want to learn another similar machine learning technique in practice, make sure to check out this video next.